an apartment because they weren't big enough, so you always had strangers. In 1942, half of the population was just about gone. Many children were orphaned because the Germans took their parents, and the children and the elderly were hiding because they were afraid to be the first victims. So the kids used to live on the streets, in empty apartments. Food allowed for a Jew in the Warsaw Ghetto was 184 calories a day, less than a bag of Sun Chips that you can buy in any store. And sometimes out of a family, maybe two or three people, and most of the times two people, would get a ration after standing and waiting or working some days. So 250 some calories would feed a family like that. What happens? The youth of the ghetto becomes the backbone of the ghetto, and they risk their lives to smuggle additional food into the ghetto. The population dwindled in 1942, but there are facts that 80% of the food eaten in the Warsaw Ghetto was smuggled in or thrown over the walls by some Gentiles that feel sorry for us, or underground. Whichever way they did it, they couldn't do a job that would sustain everybody's life.